All right, so on the left, we got Kyle Martinez. Oh my God, this is going to be so confusing. So we got Red Ken versus Blue Ken. Round Kyle one. In the red gi, John in the blue. Nice crush counter into DP, puts him all the way in the corner, and this is Kyle's patented. Are you going to grab? No. Does not confirm that standing medium kick into a full combo. And John puts himself back into the neutral state, getting himself slowly out of that corner. In Street Fighter, corner is such a huge, huge advantage. And Ken excels at pushing you into the corner. And just like that, two little sequences there. John is already in the corner. And why not? Let me just push you into the other corner. Oh my God, and Kyle getting hit by that jumping Tatsu with John's own. And John so far really dominating with these this pressure.
Wow, a lot of respect from Kyle there, not throwing any fireballs, any buttons.
And that is plus. He tries to go for some sort of frame trap. That is my oh, and he gets hit with a frame trap there, jab into back medium punch.
John taking the early lead here in our first top 8 match of the night. Oh, crazy dash in from Kyle. Very ballsy.
And just as ballsy with John with that dragon punch.
Oh, great DP says, I do not want any of your shenanigans.
Oh, tries to go for a mix-up, but doesn't V-skill to get a pressure going. Overhead.
Wow, full max distance overhead from Little John.
Kyle needs to watch out because any super... Oh, we're going to get it? No, goes for EX instead.
Definitely need to watch out for the DPs from Ken players when they have V-trigger. All they want to do is pop it.
Oh my God.
Beautiful
John.
DP. But you can't... Sweet V-skill, very unsafe.
Yeah.
Oh my God, DPs, is it?
Who can Dragon Punch the hardest?
For real.
Kyle so far... Final round. Is the one. Fight. No anti-air by Lil Jon.
Wow, beautiful anti-air from Kyle into a mix-up. Kyle slowly holding this corner, puts himself in the corner, and then puts Lil Jon back in. Kyle feel himself right now. Oh my God, wake up Dragon Punch, it's gonna get punished. Huge damage, huge corner carry. Oh my God, another combo, one more hit, it's done!
Overhead!
Beautiful overhead from Lil Jon.
And Lil Jon isn't gonna close it out yet, but he needs to watch out because Super is in there.
Oh, he dropped it! Kyle is so close to taking this back. He has a lot of meter. But oh my God, it's basically even.
Kyle needs to watch out for that. Oh, I was expecting the dragon, but didn't confirm.
Oh no!
Oh no, and Kyle going in with the dive kick. That's essentially a dive kick in this game.
Beautiful comeback from Kyle. Kyle was really far behind in that round, and it seemed like it was curtains for him. But, he put the pressure on. Little John faltered, and then he took the first game. That was crazy. I thought that was Little John's game for sure.
For sure.
For sure.
Let's see if Little John will adjust here. I've seen a lot of standing medium kicks not confirmed into their target combo. There's a lot of missed damage in this matchup.
Oh, beautiful jump in from Kyle. That's going to be big damage. Wow, Kyle seems to have found his rhythm. One more mix-up and that's stunned.
And that is every single time Lil Jon was trying to grab.
Oh my God.
And he got punished for it.
Kyle dropping the combo and DPing. Such confidence right now.
Lil Jon does have V-trigger, so he needs to watch out because that is a good comeback factor in this matchup.
Oh, dash up, deck him. Kyle took that first round so convincingly here in game two. Kyle looking really strong right now. John Perez, the blue Ken, needs to find his rhythm.
Oh, nice Shoryuken.
Again, this match though is far from over. It's first to win three games, not first to win two and here in the top eight. We want the better player to win, so we need more games to determine that. Who is the better player? Beautiful punish in that V-skill. Oh my God. John respecting Kyle too much, gets caught with a dash up grab.
No, V reversals all day.
Big punish, and Kyle, it feels like he's in Little John's head. He knows when the DPs are coming. He knows when he doesn't want a DP and just wants to sit and block. Dash up overhead. It looks like it's curtains. But John has a lot of meter. He has super. He can make this happen.
Sure you can? No.
That is oh my god, spending all the meter.
That was plus one. Every single EX Hadouken was plus on block, but he did not convert off of that with that Shoryuken.
I don't even know if that Shoryuken would link. It feels like maybe it would.
It would, because there's a juggle potential in fireballs. With the
first to three. First to three. It's top eight.
So this is what's scary, because Kyle inadvertently has an advantage regardless of this match because he has multiple characters he can play.
Yeah.
And in the first to three, he has all that wiggle room.
I don't even know, though, if Kyle would consider himself a multi-character player as of right now, because I've only seen him play Ken for the past at least month or so.
Oh, yeah, you've been playing with him a lot online. That's
yeah, I have been spending a lot of time with Kyle online. He's primarily a Ken player.
He is not Bison anymore. No more Bison.
He can play Bison, but he knows Ken is the much better pick, and Ken just seems to be flowing with him. Little John down two games right now.
Oh, no, he drops his combo. He was looking for back medium punch there for sure.
It's never over until it's over. Little John can most definitely make this comeback, but he cannot be letting punches like that get away from him. Really, really ballsy dragon punches from Kyle here. Oh, Kyle or Little John going all the way to a Shoryuken, even though it did not hit early on.
Little John going nuts there. It's match point for Kyle.
Yeah, now this could be the final round if Kyle takes this round right here, right now.
See if John can recover. He is on life support right now.
I mean, it's admirable to make it all the way up to top eight, but you don't want to go out 3-0 right when you make it to top eight. Beautiful anti-air.
Nice grab by Lil Jon. Sets his offensive going to, and he drops his block string. Misses that jumping medium kick. I don't know why.
Oh, nice dive kick. Beautiful hurricane kick from Kyle.
Ken's EX hurricane kick is arguably one of the better dive kicks in this game, plus on block.
Oh, it's one of the best dive kicks in this game.
For sure.
Only thing stopping it from being the best is that it costs a bar.
Yeah, for sure.
Wow, great patience from Kyle here. Even though it's even, it still feels like it's Kyle's lead, but a beautiful confirm from John there.
Oh, if he had V-Trigger, that would have been it.
John so close to closing out this round. Definitely has the lead. Oh, crazy hurricane kick.
Just watch out, because Super's in there.
Beautiful blocks, but you can't block forever. Oh, too early with the grab. Baits out the Super, and this is a punish.
This is huge. Kyle using all his bar, nothing for the next round. Can't dive kick anymore.
Kyle went all in with that wake up Super. He lost all of his meter. Those are really important resources.
I respect that, Kyle. I respect that.
And you know, it's great for Little John's confidence to get a round on the board. Now he's only one round away from getting his first game and making this a much more probable comeback.
Nice view reversal, gets out that pressure.
Beautiful pressure from Little John, but then backs off. I really respect that. It can't always be your turn. Oh, drops are beautiful space jump. No anti-air.
Oh, he has V trigger available and one bar. Oh, and he gets the hit.
Beautiful confirm. That's a lot of damage. Little John so close to taking his first game.
Oh, he bet the farm on that one.
He's not dead, but he's so close to dead. Little John needs to survive this mix-up. Overhead. And Kyle takes it 3-0.
Ken wins.
Little John is out at seventh place. He is going to win $7.
Hey. He can still win the raffle, though.
Oh, yeah, he can still win the raffle.
He's qualified for the raffle.
So for those of you who are just joining us, the Rackham Battle Royale, we currently have 22 players in the tournament who all pay 10 bucks each. That's 220, plus a $500 cash pot bonus provided by the bar.
Yeah, Rackham Billiards been the home for the FGC since, I believe, March.
Yeah.
Been giving us this venue for Thursday Night Throwdowns and finally Rackham Royale. really good place.
So John gets 1% of the pot at 7th place. He gets $7.
$7.
Seven whole dollars.
You know what you can do? You can buy a Jack and Coke.
You can go. Yeah, you can buy a Jack and Coke. You can have, I think, just fries at King's. No ranch. No Pico Ranch.
Hey,
I'm sorry.
4 for $4 at Wendy's. You still got time.
All right. And then up next, can I get Joseph Garrido and Aldwin Blanco?
Oh, this is nuts. These guys
Joseph
have
Garrido and Aldwin Blanco.
These guys have a history